How's everybody doing today? What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Jerry from the Dungeon. Today, I love telling these story times about my childhood. I'm probably gonna have more stories as I get older. It's a special story, a really special story. I had this on my mind all day, and I can't wait to tell you about this story about how a fight happened before my championship game. This happened in the seventh grade. It was a crazy experience for me. Keep showing love, keep supporting. I love the support. I love the energy that you guys are giving towards my family and all of us, and we love it. So we can't do this journey without y'all. So get us to 2K. There'll be a special story time at 2K. Tune into my last story time. Thanks for all the support. We're gone.
Oh no! I can't.
Good, G.
Oh!
How do you handle fame?
I am a film by not being famous.
So, this story took place in the seventh grade. I don't want to go too deep into my basketball story because that's for like another story time. But just know in the seventh grade, my Julie's right there. We were really good. I feel like one of our best teams. I'm so good that I made it to the championship round. That championship game took place in Redbuds High School. So before our championship game, usually that's the cases with travel basketball. There's games before the actual like big game. And they had a big game before us. So we got there early, obviously, to stretch, get ready for the game. This is a big competition. My coach name was Jimmy. His son played for us too. His son was really one of the best point guards I played with. Alejandro, a lot of teammates that I played with that were really good. Brandon. Well, we all were getting ready before the game, stretching. Because this is championship chance, really, that year to win. Like, win something special for the team. So anyway, that's semi-important, but not really important. I remember the game before us was packed. When I say a lot of kids, a lot of parents, and it's travel basketball around 13, 14 years old. Parents, grandparents, uncles, packed before the game. Packed. We just were surprised how packed it was because I don't even think that was a championship game for their level. I think that might have been a semi-final. Sometimes when the team loses, they hold a game for the losers to play. Just because, like, it's still kids, you want to teach them a little something about the game. I guess that was one of those games for them. The game was a pack. It was an all-white team and it was an all-black team. The game was so intense that, basketball fan, we had to go back and watch after. We could even have a full discussion about our game. Screw that. We're going to have our discussion later. Let's go watch this game. They're scrapping, going back and forth. And I think the all-black team was up. Team was more shooters. Like, they shot from the more outside, but the black team was more, like, physical, but they start to get worn out as the game progressed, right? But during the game, they were trash talking. So let me say this. At that level, trash talking is not the best thing. There's a reason why the refs don't allow it. The refs cut it out. At that level, you can't really comprehend and separate trash talk from the game. Like, that level, like, you're 13, 14 years old. Somebody tells you about your mother in the middle of the game, you're gonna lose it. Like, you can't really control that, right? That was basically the case. They were trash talking back and forth. The black team was up there like, yeah, in your face, all that, da 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 da. Kids going back and forth. And the ref, he's supposed to, so that happens in the first half, cut it out. But he didn't. He was letting it happen. And the game was so loud and intense and the bench was into it, everything like that. Like, I don't even think the ref could have handled it. We couldn't handle it. And we actually, I'm not gonna lie, we're enjoying it. So this is the second half. There's two halves in the game, 15-15. If you don't play basketball, you don't know. Second half of the game, all white team starts to come back. Shoot threes, bang, bang, bang. Shooting threes, coming back now. Remember, the black team was talking trash while they're beating on the white kids, but now the white team is starting to come back. So now when the white team is coming back, yeah, the white team is starting to talk trash. I'm like, yeah, we're here. What? What's up? What's going on? And the black team is like, wow. They're almost shook. The coach is calling timeouts. Like, he can't control it. And they had one kid on the team who was ultra aggressive. I remember him. He was ultra aggressive. Like, and we were all like, okay, this kid might have a little bit of anger issues. Like, it's not that deep. But them in the middle of the game and how packed it was and the atmosphere was so hot. I wouldn't blame him, like, about how he was behaving. Like, the white team comes back. Remember, they were talking trash. So apparently in the middle of the game, everybody's talking trash, right? Most important conversation for between one black and another team that was ultra aggressive, the one I told you about that was giving the hard fouls, and another white kid, right? Apparently, as the black kid was starting to loop and the white kid was talking trash, he was like, yeah, keep talking that. Like I said before, they can't handle the trash talking. He said, I'm gonna meet you outside after the game. Keep talking like that. So remember, he can't separate basketball from trash talk, right? Whatever the case is, we're thinking it's done. To be honest, I don't really care. Like, and you can still feel like some sadness from the black team because they were up like a lot of points. Let's say 15-20 and the white kids just came back and it hurts when you came back and you're talking trash. Anyways, start to go into court now, get ready for our the real championship game where we get hoodies and stuff and trophies or whatever the case is, right? There's an MVP and all that. We're in layup lines, right? Oh, play. Let's go, let's get started. Go on layups, whatever the case is. Other teams shaking hands. So other teams shaking hands. Everybody in the gym, the losing team and the winning team is still, both teams that are about to play are still in layup lines. If you don't know what layup lines are, one team's on the other side shooting a layup, the other team's on the other side shooting a layup, getting ready for the game to warm up. Happening, the other team is congratulating, oh, good game, bro, good game, good game. So while that's happening, I think I tilt my head like this, and all I see as they're saying, good game, good game, good game, the black kid holds the white kid's hand, right? And now, boom! Like that, this rock, I see rocking, right? So everybody in the gym sees that. So we're like, yo, what? Like, what just happened? Like, as this happens, right? Coach immediately knows where the clap came from. It sounded like a thunderclap. Really rocked. Like, yo, when I see this guy, he rocked everything. He did not miss a beat. So I think immediately the coach knows where the clap comes from. He grabs the boy because the boy wants more. And remember, while this is happening, as soon as he punched him, this is a frail white kid. A bunch of blood comes down right all over the place. Pool of blood. A serious pool of blood. Immediately, teams get separated. One thing I can credit North Buzzard for, and really, like, as soon as the fight breaks out, things get separated so fast. Like, the boy wanted more. Like, he could even get more. He could even get a second punch in. Like, he only got that one thunderclap. The coach grabbed him. Everything got set. The kid's sister comes back, comes down, is like, hey, what did my brother do? I want my brother. I want my brother. Why is she wilding like this? Because if anything, like, your brother's wrong. Like, what is going on? And we can't even be on the court because there's a big pool of blood. Everybody in the room is shocked, right? So as it happened, it was a huge silence. Yeah, like the kid had to go outside and get aired. The kid got suspended for the whole next season to do that. He said, I was going to meet you outside after the game. And he'd even meet him outside. He actually went against his word. He just knocked him straight in his face. The boy's sister, the one had to get held by the cops because the sister wanted to go after the white parents. Your brother's wrong. Yes, bro. I'm still in shock thinking about this necklace. Like, yeah, I never seen anything like it. Can't do that without y'all. So make sure to like, comment, subscribe. Make sure you tune into my next videos. And we're out. Yeah, they want to eat off my plate. And that, it's so, big ass, how I get that, ooh.